Hi folks, this is Andre Boyer with Serpico News, right in your face. Folks, like I said before, the incident in the Starbucks, I told you from the door, Commissioner Ross didn't know what he was talking about. I knew from being a former Philadelphia police officer that these cops did wrong. This call was absolutely unwarranted, and I knew the arrest was unwarranted. Now, if I knew that, and I was no longer on the department, Richard Ross, your police commissioner, should have known this. But here's one for you, even better. He's the police commissioner. Why would you make a statement and do a video and hand it out to the press without even doing an investigation? That shows you this guy doesn't have a clue to what he's doing. He's like an ostrich with his head in the sand and his ass in the air, and the mayor handed it to him. The only reason why he came out today and made a national apology is because the mayor made him. You can say whatever you want, but my sources don't lie.
Starbucks customers, not everyone is aware that people spend long hours in Starbucks and aren't necessarily expected to make a purchase. I've had multiple discussions over the last few days, and it is a well-known fact, but a widespread belief that everyone knows that about Starbucks. I'm here to tell you that I did not, and it is also reasonable to believe that the officers didn't know it either, as I have spoken to a number of people who are not Starbucks customers who are not aware. I was under the belief that people went there and they spent hours and hours, but that the expectation was that they bought something first. I was not aware of that, and so that is on me. I can appreciate, in light of the Starbucks policy and how well known it is to many, why these two men were appalled when they were asked to leave. For this reason, I apologize to them. We have already completed a new policy that guides our officers on how to deal with similar situations. Previously, we did not have such a policy because it is nearly impossible to have a policy for every criminal or any other violation. But we have a policy now, and I'm not going to go into it at this point in time, but we'll be pushing that out at a later date. There are also questions regarding the 911 dispatch call and how it was different than the requests for assistance. A disturbance call, and this is 29 years for me, is one of the lowest priority calls that we have. And while I can understand why people hearing or seeing the radio dispatch difference, it is nothing that alarms police officers whatsoever. It's just a way that these calls are put out. Many of you in the press or who have scanners know that we do not operate under a 10-code system, meaning we don't use codes. We just spell out exactly what the job is. And so this would just be one example, and it's just a generic way to say that there's an issue at a particular location. One thing that is evident in this case is that from reviewing the evidence and having seen...
Yeah, one thing that's evident in this case is the mayor is making you be accountable for giving false and inaccurate information to the public.